Hello, I am Lyric, your optophysical artist. Today is a video for the Juicy. It's another one. I think I only done one so far, and I kept telling you all that I was going to come back and do multiple of them. I've been making them, but I just haven't been doing the videos. It takes a lot to set up to do the videos. It really does. But anyway, we're about to do one today because I need to get some stocked in my refrigerator. I've been a naughty girl and I haven't always been eating right. I either don't eat at all or I lay around and I snack. I love like salsa and chips and dips and beer. Those are my favorite combination to lay down in my bed and watch a movie. So I gotta do better. I really do. It's like 1 second in quarantine, I'll start to lose weight, and then the next, I just start eating up everything. Like, ah. So if I have the Juicies at hand when I feel hungry, I'll drink one of those, and then the hunger goes away. And then I don't do the miscellaneous snacking. I really don't want anything. All right? So in this blend, we're gonna, I have probably about a little over a cup of blueberries, and I have a cup of the frozen, and the blueberries were frozen too. Okay, so I have them in the blender because I wanted them to kind of thaw out a little bit, but I have avocados that were frozen, blueberries that were frozen, and then my ginger. When I buy ginger, after I wash it, I cut it up and I keep it in a bag in the refrigerator. So it was frozen as well. So that's what's in here so far, is blueberries, avocados, and ginger. Yes. So I have some cilantro. I've already washed it, so it's waiting. So let's go ahead and start to add our ingredients in. I have some turmeric here. And I'm gonna stick to a tablespoon of everything today. Yeah, I think I'm going to, well, with the exception of the salt and pepper, but we're going to add in a tablespoon of the turmeric. A little over. I'm trying to be good and measure a little bit. Y'all know I hate to measure stuff. It's just not my thing. All right. Then we have our chia seeds. Now, I usually add chia seeds to my water as well. Just a regular bottle of water, I usually take a tablespoon and add to my water. If I have these things made in advance, it just makes it easier. And you know what? I'm not going to put that in there because I don't want it ground up. I'm going to put them in here. So we're going to put a tablespoon. Can you all see the bottles? Hold on. Let me move things around here, okay? So you can see what I got going on over here. These are my empty water bottles that I keep. And I have so many of them over here on the floor that it's beyond ridiculous. And I'm about ready to start throwing them out. But mainly it's because I hadn't been making the Juicies. Because once I use them, after I add the Juicy mix to them and I use it, drink it up, I throw the bottle away then. I may keep the top, but I throw the bottle away. Alright, so we're just going to add in a cup of chia seeds to each bottle. And the reason I didn't put it in the blender is because I want to make sure that I get the full tablespoon in each drink. Okay. How's everybody? Y'all been all right with quarantine? Huh? You been keeping your wits about yourself? Are y'all flipping out yet? Huh? Are you losing your minds? I have been perfectly fine as far as being in the house because I am somewhat of a recluse anyway. I'm not really a person that socializes a whole lot. But I know a lot of people. Isn't that crazy? Well, a lot of people know me. I'm extremely popular. It's crazy, but I am very reclusive and I keep to myself. I mind my own damn business. That's what I do. So I'm going to add in a little pepper. How much? I don't know. There we go. We got to add a little pepper. The pepper is a carrier to the turmeric. I think I had a definition of that before, that I had looked up some information about the turmeric and the black pepper. They need to be together in order to bring forth their power. So we're going to add in our collagen now. There's a scoop already in here. So I'm going to add in... Now, normally, that's what I add in my cup of coffee. So I had coffee or tea, whichever I have. This morning I had coffee. So when I have coffee, I fill up this and I put it in my cup. But since we have 2, 4, 6, 8 bottles here, I'm going to add in 2 scoops. Ooh, I was so daring, wasn't I? Let's add in 3, okay? Let's add in 3. And that'll do it for that. Okay? So we got our turmeric in. We got our collagen in. We got our flaxseed in. Oh, I got a new immune system fighting element to add to it. This is called elderberry. And I had seen some videos about how well elderberry builds your immune system, and that is what we need more than ever right now with the whole Rona. But the thing is that sickness and disease is among us all the time. So Rona is not even something new. It's just been supersized. She went crazy on this, man. But it's not new. There really aren't anything new. It's just new to us. But disease and viruses and things like that have always been around. It's just a matter of us keeping up our immune system to be able to fight those things off. And unfortunately, we don't always eat properly, so our immune systems are compromised. And that's the truth of the matter. So now you have to intentionally make sure that you put things in your body that will help your immune system be stronger, okay, intentionally. I am not a person that typically catches a lot of things because I really do, but I would say 90% of the time, I always intake things that build my immune system, okay? So like I said, I'm a naughty girl, so I like my beer and my alcohol. I really do, and I like to smoke every now and again, but I make sure that I clean those things out. And that's all. That's really all it is. It's what goes in. You have to make sure it comes out and it doesn't have time to settle and become something. So diseases and things don't just, boom, you got it. No. It has to sit within you for a certain amount of time to grow. Okay? So you don't just, you know, come in contact with something and you instantly have it. That's not how things work. You have to continuously not take care of your immune system, and then things settle, and then it turns into a monster. Okay? So just know that. All right. Now let me find out about this Oh, it smells wonderful. This is a syrup. I bought this one on Amazon. Sambucus elderberry syrup, immune system support, made from 100% pure elderberry. Powerful antioxidant, supports the immune system. It's a non-GMO ingredient. It tastes great, and it was made in the USA. How about that? So let's see how much it says. It says take 1 teaspoon. What, daily? I'm assuming it must be daily. Alright, so if it says 1 teaspoon, I'm going to go ahead and put in this. I'm going to stick to the tablespoon, and I'm just going to put the whole tablespoon in there. It smells really good. Alright, so I'm just going to put in the whole tablespoon. And then, what do we have here? Nothing? think I put everything in there. Yeah? Yeah. Let's go ahead and add our cilantro. Cilantro is another good detox. Cleans your immune system, pulls mercury out your system. Again, food is medicine. So you either gonna pay for healthy food or you're gonna be paying for medication. But you will pay. Make no doubt about that. Okay? So let's get this going. We're gonna go ahead and add some water to it. This is the Primo water from Walmart. You know, you go to the machine. So I went yesterday and got all my little grocery shopping and things done. Here's my pineapple juice. All right. Pop that open. All right. Put a little bit in. Just to get this rocking and rolling, I'm going to sit this in the sink, because once this starts to vibrate around, things may start to fall apart here. I don't want things on the floor. Oh, you know, I didn't add any honey. Let me add some honey. I always like mine just a little bit sweet, just because I'm going to dilute this probably with some more water. And I don't like it to taste bland. Alright, did I add my salt in there? Did you want to see me add sprinkle salt in there? Huh? The sea salt will preserve it, but it also balances the sweet out a little bit. If I didn't, it'd be alright. Okay, so let's give her a blend. Oh, am I on? What happened? Oh! Had to hit the power first. That did it. I was talking to my cousin and we were talking about how sometimes when you're making smoothies and things like that, you add too much stuff to it. So I had to, here I go, every time. Oh, God, why? It's fighting me. There. God, I swear, I think sometimes it just be doing stuff to get me to knock stuff over just because it's good for you. Sometimes things that's good for you, there are outside forces that always want to interfere with it. So you got to fight through. You got to be careful, but you got to fight through. You see me fight through? All right. All right, now let's get this in here. Now, I'm not going to fill them up. I'm just going to add just enough to the bottles because we're going to fill it up the rest of the way with pineapple juice and with water. Like I said, my cousin and I were talking about how much ingredients. I used to have so many things in here that it was hard to even blend it all. And it's unnecessary. So I just had to slow my roll. I don't have to add it all. least they had some stuff. I'd like to know if you all have tried any of these yet. Huh? Have you tried any of my recipes? Have you? Are y'all jiving me? Huh? Are you jiving me? I want to know. And even if you didn't, I want to know why you didn't. What's going on at your house? Huh? What you doing that you couldn't make this, Lyric Originals juicy and get yourself all healthy? What is happening in your life? Oh, I got a little bit left. Which one is going to get it? Huh? How are we looking over there? Looking pretty good. I think I'm going to give this one right here the last little bit. Yep, that's it. So then, get back on my pineapple juice. I like to put it in here. I used to just pour it from the can inside the bottle, but I want to make sure that I get all the goodies outside of this blender and not wash it down the drain. I found it's better for me to just stir it up instead of turning it on because it becomes all frothy and it's hard to get all that froth in the bottle. It slows the process down. So it's just easier to put it in here and then just give it a little stir to clean up the sides. Okay? So now we're just going to fill it up. Well, really not even all the way up because the pineapple juice is really sweet, and I already know that the mixture is fine. I just know. You notice I didn't taste it? It's because I just know. I'm good. I may have to crack open another pineapple juice. Yeah, I'm going to have to crack open another pineapple juice. So we're going to have to add just a little more juice there, kids. And ta-da! Now this one, I may not need to add the whole can. Let's see. Because too much pineapple juice will give me heartburn. It used not, but it does now. So I have to dilute it with a little water. Did I hit them all? Huh? I think I did. I'm going to taste it after I, after I finish them. Now, I'm not going to tell you that this process isn't a little messy. I got pineapple juice dripping right now. I got smoothie drip on the counter. It's a messy process. It really is. So I'm not going to even tell you like, oh, it's just that easy and a snap. No, it's not. You're going to have a little mess here. I think I got enough pineapple juice in there. I think the rest of it I can just add water in. But so far, I'm not making as big of a mess as I would. I'm trying to take my time and not rush the process. When I rush it is when I start to make a mess of things. And I think this is it. We're good. Give them all a shake. We're going to taste one of them. Okay, and then I'm going to put them in the Frigidaire. And they'll be there for when I go to work. I can just grab one on my way out the door. Because they do help keep me from eating. Actually, it's a lot of sweet. It really is. I like sweet. But sweets love me so much that they like to hang around my tummy area. They don't want to leave me. We love one another. But when I drink smoothies, it cuts back on my sugar craving. It really does. I don't crave it as much. Okay? Wipe this off. Got a little mess here. And then my chia seeds. Oh, I forgot about them. The chia seeds, make sure you shake that up, because if you don't, they will start to stick together and then they'll stay in the bottom of the bottle. Like even now, I should have had water already in there and I knew that. I really did. It's, again, when you're doing the videos, at least it is for me, certain things I just forget at that moment. But if I wasn't doing the video, I would normally remember. It's just that there's a lot of little things to do these videos. And it's not as simple as I just turn on my phone. I do my videos on a camera. So I have to set up lights and tripods and put in bulbs and move the lamps and get them where the lighting is good. So it's not as simple as you just turn on your phone. Not for me, it's not. I think the quality of the picture or the video looks better with the camera than it does versus my phone. You know, I do the phone ones for my Let's Cook at Home channel. Well, it's not a channel, I'm sorry. My Let's Cook at Home Facebook page. My Lyric Originals Facebook page. I may do things with the camera then. I mean, with my phone. But when I do these, I want you to have a better quality, a better image. So I go through the extra steps of setting up a for real camera. It opens the door for me to forget little things. You know, I remember this and forget that. Yeah, see, it's stuck really bad in there. Once it sticks, it's over. You're not getting that out of there. It's not gonna solidify and float up to the top. It will just... It'll solidify in the bottom, and it's just stuck like glue. So, there's my mess up, all right? So, you just remember that going forward. When you add your chia seeds, make sure you have some water already in there, or some juice or something, but have a liquid already in there. It's easier, for, like I said, when I add chia seeds to my bottled water, because it's already water in the bottle. Add the seeds in, put the top back on it. They'll swell up. Okay? So let's give one of them a taste, and that will be it. Do this. Hey, that's really good. I can really taste the, I can taste the elderberry. Hey, this is good. It's good. You want to try this one? Try this one. Less really was more. I didn't cram all the things in it that I normally be trying to push it off in there. I didn't do that this time. Just kept the ingredients to a minimum. When it's cold, it's really going to be good. But yeah, we made it with this one. We did it, kids. We did it. So yes, here is your juicy. Again, it's not a smoothie. It's a juicy just because I add so much water and pineapple juice to it. So it's not thick. All right, smoothies are thick and you need that big ass monster straw. With this one, I have it thin enough where you can drink it straight through your water bottle caps. So that's it. All right, make sure that if you like the video that you subscribe to the page, give it a thumbs up, post it on your Facebook page, and let's all work together to keep each other healthy and sane in this crazy world we are in right now. Isn't this wild? It's madness out here. I'm like, this is really freaking happening. Well, anyway, I'm going to continue to do what I do. I'm going to take care of Lyric and mind Lyric's own business. I go to work, and I'm going to try to eat healthy and still, you know, do my little naughty things because that's just what I do. It's the perfect balance, okay? You're a little naughty, you're a little nice, all right? So you all take care. Take care of yourself. Take care of your people if you can. If they let you, if they don't, peace them out. And take care of yourself because you are your number one priority. You really are. You are your number one priority. Without you, nothing else matters. It really doesn't. Take care of you. All right? Till next time, keep a lyric in your heart. Bye-bye.